Hello, Orange Army. How are you all?
Fine, bro. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine, bro. I'm doing well.
Hello, bro. How are you?
All good. All
how
good.
Is the quarantine going on?
Yeah, good. Yes. Yeah, guys. In these days, we are badly missing IPL. So by this, this made me remember our old matches. Of all of these, my favorite was 2016 final. Of course, not my favorite. It's all everybody's favorite. So guys, welcome to the podcast 4. In this podcast, we are going to discuss about 2016 final. So we have Puneet, Rakshit, Yashwant, and Abhilash. Hi guys. Yeah. So guys, Rakshit, say me your thoughts about IPL 2016.
IPL 2016 was something grateful for Sunrise Hyderabad fans. Sunrise Hyderabad, our season dominated chala yesindi, especially David Warner, the way he led Sunrise Hyderabad to the final of IPL 2016 was great. And bowlers did great that season. Mustafa Azhar, Bhuvaneshwar Kumar, Karan Sharma. No, and the final was with RCB in Chinnaswamy Stadium in their home ground. And we winning that match was historical for us. And it was a great moment for us. For Orange Army, it was something great moment.
Puneet bhai, aap kya karte ho IPL 2016 ke bare mein?
IPL 2016 का फाइनल, फर्स्टली इट वॉज अ वेरी इमोशनल मोमेंट पर्सनली फॉर मी, ऑब्वियसली एवरीबडी, मतलब जितने भी फैंस है सबके लिए. फॉर मी बिकॉज 2012 वी लॉस्ट डेक्कन चार्जर्स, सिंस देन वी हैड सनराइजर्स एज अ न्यू टीम एंड इट वॉज नोबडी वॉज टेकिंग सीरियसली. पीपल यूज टू मेक फन ऑफ द टीम, बट मी एंड फ्यू ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स वी सपोर्टेड द टीम फ्रॉम डे वन. And seeing them becoming the champions in 2016, I literally cried in front of my screen. So that was one thing which gave me a belief in myself that if you support something from zero, when you achieve the success, the joy will be something on another level. The best thing about that entire season was our batting side and our bowling side was completely balanced. If you look at RCB, they had heavy batting side, but bowling unit was pathetic. So that is the reason they couldn't come up with the final, because everybody had written off Sunrisers Hyderabad when they were about to face RCB in their home ground in the final. But when we turned the tables around, everybody was shocked and finally we became the champions. So it was a very emotional moment for me and a proud moment for all the SRH fans.
So Yashwant, say me your thoughts about IPL 2016.
Bro, 2016 final was the amazing final I have never seen in my life. It was a nail-biting match between RCB and Sunrisers Hyderabad. So, the crowd was fully like it was the orange and red. The crowd was fully of cheering Sunrisers Hyderabad and RCB. As it was in the Chinnaswamy Stadium, there were a lot of RCB fans. So, the game was very nail-biting game for us. Finals, it was like Dhawan, Warner, the opening pair started with a good partnership and again the Hendrikes, Yuvraj Singh, followed by the members in a team was going well with the batting order. The game was very well gone with the RCB event too. The bowlers were pretty impressive for RCB. To say it was a very nail-biting match for us.
Yeah, thank you, Yashwant. Abhilash.
So my experience with 2016, I watched all the league matches live on TV, but I missed both the eliminator and qualifier too because of the I had intermediate improvement exams. That's the reason why I missed those matches. I was very interested about that, and I I was caught by my JL when I was seeing the score, and both the times, both the days, the qualifier 2 and eliminator match. And I was the next day, the day when the match is completed, the next day we were given holidays, the exams were completed, and next day the final. So the day before the final, I felt I'm very lucky. At least I'm watching the final of our match, and it started with David Warner's innings of massive 60-65 odd, I don't remember exactly. He was on fire. Even Shikhar Dhawan has contributed well in that power play. And later, Warner kept the tempo up. He started hitting sixes. I remember 1-6 wins. He played a sweep shot and hit. It was Iqbal Abdullah, I think. I don't remember the bowler name. And then Henriquez, he didn't contribute that game. And Yuvraj Singh, I think that's where the match has changed. The momentum, we got it there. Then I scored around 30 out of 16 balls or 18. I don't remember the number of balls. And then came Ben Cutting. All of us know what has happened. Eight big sixes. I think 26 runs or 28 runs of Shane Watson's over. That kept my feeling strong that we are going to lift this cup for sure. Because on final 208 versus RCB, with our bowling, I thought that we are going to win the cup. But when the RCB innings started, it all went, turned the scenario. I thought we are winning, and I started keep losing my hope. And during power play, I think they were 70 or 75 for, I think, till then Gale started playing, and Virat was not, didn't play that much. And later, 10 overs, they were 114 for 0. I thought, man, we are going to lose this match. Then my father is a very good cricket fan. He kept me, no, we are definitely winning this. Don't worry. If we'll get them those 2 wickets, we are going to win for sure. And I believed my father. And you know what has happened is Ben Cutting has took Gale's wicket of Bipul Sharma. He came running and took that wonderful catch. And then Kohli started his game. He played, I think, then before that he was 20 of some 13 or 14 balls, I don't remember. And then he started playing. He was on fire. And then Barinder Sran, that off cutter, don't know what it is called, but I think it's off cutter, slow ball, he bowled Kohli. And that's where I got confident. The next over, Bipul Sharma, the man. I think Bipul Sharma should be noted. Every SRH fan will definitely remember him. If you go to eliminator match, the innings he have played, we know. The qualifier 2 match also, he contributed a lot. Without him, I think would have been very difficult for David Warner for hitting those big innings. And then Bipul Sharma bowled a slower one, took AB de Villiers' wicket, and then I got confident. Yes, we are winning this. I shouted at that point, and from that ball, every ball, I was shouting, yes, 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 we are winning this. And later, after Bhuvneshwar Kumar has given last over, even Bhuvneshwar Kumar was very involved in that match. He even scored Naman Ojha, if you remember, because he actually the run out has happened. Then he was throwing the ball, but no one has caught the ball. Bhuvneshwar was shouting on Naman Ojha, what are you doing? Kya kar rahe tu? This was the thing happened. You know, we won the World Cup. Sorry, IPL.
Thank you, Abhilash.
I think credit should be given for David Warner and bowling department. Definitely, that season, now whole team has definitely given their performance. They played well.
And Ben Cutting was a key point.
Yes.
Yeah. So, guys, according to me, my 4 best moments were David Warner innings and Ben Cutting hard hitting and Virat Kohli and Chris Gayle's wicket and RCB's batting downfall. So guys, Punit bhai, how important was dead runner innings at that match.
It was the most important innings of SRH batting lineup as well as David Warner's career with IPL. Because he took it on his shoulders to, you know, leading from the front with complete pressure. There was, I think, 10% or 5% SRH fans in the stadium. And you have all the fans cheering for RCB. Even if you play in Hyderabad, you have fans cheering for RCB. So there is the total opposite scenario. But he took it leading from the front. That was a very good innings from David Warner. And then secondly...
Continue.
Yeah, second... I'll just tell my four important things from that. Second thing was small cameo, but effective from Yuvraj Singh. If you see, he joined us after 7 matches.
Yes, yes, yes.
And he scored, I think, 41 in 22 balls.
Yeah, yeah, 41.
39 of 40 around in 20 balls, yeah.
So that was 27 balls.
Correct. He hit three sixes.
So in 15 overs, we were almost around 145. So that changed the momentum of the game. And the third best thing was Ben batting. I remember his statement when he said, when he was given, I think he was given man of the match in that final. Because he took wickets and he scored those runs. So he just said that the boys needed it tonight. Yeah, the boys needed it tonight, so I had to deliver. And he did that. So that was the one big moment. And the best part was Vipul Sharma and Varinder Singh.
Yeah.
Taking wickets of Virat Kohli and AB De Villiers.
AB De Villiers, yeah.
I remember the commentary also. Virat Kohli gone, AB De Villiers, yeah, AB De Villiers RCB gone. In deep, deep trouble.
Yeah. Yeah, guys, I think not only the innings of David Warner and Ben Cutting, innings of Dhawan and Yuvraj Singh were also great. They gave very great support. So, after losing David Warner wicket also, we didn't lose our hopes because of Yuvraj Singh.
Momentum.
Yeah, because of Yuvraj Singh. He's there. We didn't lose hope. So, Rakshit, tell me what do you say about Ben Cutting's innings?
Manam appudu score chusukunte matram koncham low unde. And appudu Ben Cutting vachesi 39 runs ichindu 15 balls la. I think the strategy was hard hitting guys. Always have someone in the team who attacks the side. And if we see the past season, it was Carlos Brathwaite, and 2016 it was Ben Cutting who helped us with the bat and ball. So he attacked very well the side and put a pressure on the each end of RCB.
Yeah.
I still remember that Ben Cutting's 24 runs at the last over helped Sunrisers Hyderabad to reach the 207 target. He was the 19 point first over, the first ball, the smash, which was out of the Chinnaswamy Stadium.
Yeah. Second ball, it went on to the incomplete speed.
MG Road. It's on MG Road tonight.
That shot was pretty impressive. That shot was pretty impressive by Ben Cutting. He had just middled the ball of Shane Watson, who had bowled the full toss. And the crowd cheered was just awesome.
Yeah, Yashwant. So, after 10 overs, RCB batting after 10 overs. So, did you leave hope on the Sunrisers Hyderabad?
Yeah. I'm saying really, after the 10 overs where RCB was around 100 runs, I obviously thought that Sunrisers Hyderabad would lose the game. I was about to cry. Like, how well our guys fought the match. We had done a very impressive score. 208 is a very big target in Chinnaswamy. I didn't expect that Chris Gayle and Virat Kohli would do a very best batsman at the opening part. And Chris Gayle was just awesome. The Gayle Storm. Just all the Orange Army fans were just shouting like, what happened? Sunrisers Hyderabad, come on. They were going on cheering Sunrisers Hyderabad to take the wicket. And finally, the Bipul Sharma's magic has done and taken the wicket of the main batsman. where again the Virendra Swaran as taken with the off cutter Virat Kohli's wicket. That was the key moment for Sunrisers Hyderabad to remove the best openers of RCB. That's my point of view, where after 10 overs, where I almost cried that Sunrisers Hyderabad would lose the game. After that, the magic of Vipul Sharma and Virendra Swaran was back the game of Sunrisers Hyderabad.
Yeah, Abhilash, how do you feel the sudden downfall of RCB batting?
That I think my father, as I said before, my father told that if we get both of these batsmen, we'll definitely win. We are going to win this because they don't have, they have players but have that potential, but they were not consistent that season. If you see Shane Watson, he didn't play that season very well, even batting with batting and bowling. Then they had KL Rahul. KL Rahul was emerging player that season. He also, I think he only played few, one or two matches. And then we have Sachin Bedi. Sachin Bedi, he is a good, the final standard player, to be honest. And then we had, we lost both of those wickets and we kept the pressure back on them. They're very tired. And after 12 hours, we have three hours of Mustafizur Rahman. Because Ben Cutting and Hendricks, we used to have two handy medium pacers, Hendricks and Ben Cutting. They covered the initial overs and Mustafizur Rahman's over was saved after 10 overs. We had 3 hours of him bowling. Then we know how effective he was. So I think 3 overs of his and two Bhuvneshwar Kumar's overs, so 5 overs of their spell. So that's how way it has changed.
That's it. See, firstly, chasing 200 plus is not easy with any of the batting lineup. Even if you have a hardcore batting lineup, you're under pressure when you're chasing it. So, and you have the best bowling unit in front of you. No matter how good your batting lineup is, somewhere the pressure hits you. So, that's what happened with RCB after 11th or 12th over. And they lost one wicket. Still, Virat was going. When they lost Virat, they lost the momentum.
Yeah.
So, AB de Villiers also was a key player for RCB. Even we thought that ABD can do some magic and turn the match for RCB. But even that also can't happen because the Vipul Sharma's slower one takes the wicket of AB de Villiers and the SRH was back to game at that moment.
That was Vipul Sharma's slowest ball in the entire tournament.
Yeah.
76 kilometers per hour.
76, yeah.
That too into pressure.
AB de Villiers recently in his Instagram live, he said that after seeing the highlights, Saimbeta, he always feels bad after seeing that highlights of 2006. Why did I play that shot? He was saying with Virat Kohli in his Instagram live.
But all the entire credit goes to the entire mindset of SRH camp. Yes, because if you see the entire season, we haven't scored 200 plus.
Yes.
And in the final, we just hit it out of the park.
Yeah.
It was a team effect, guys. If you see, David Warner was orange cap holder and Bhuvneshwar was a purple cap holder.
Purple.
And Mr. Rehman was the first foreigner emerging player of IPL. And it was something, a team effort, and it will always be cherished in our life. The moment of IPL 2016.
I feel everybody bowled very well at a final match.
Yeah. When we won Deccan Chargers was champions in 2009, we had the purple cap. Even in 2016, it was the same.
Yes.
So that is something.
The coincidence. Something is coincidence.
Yeah.
And I still remember that day. Band was going on around Hyderabad. Bhutto and everything. It was memorable day.
After I was all on the streets.
After 2011 World Cup, it was IPL 2011 where we have seen that celebration in Hyderabad.
Yeah.
2016.
Do you know, guys, Star Sports is going to telecast the 2016 final match tomorrow 3 p.m. So we got a chance tomorrow, to relive 3 p.m. the historical match. Let's relive it tomorrow. So guys, thank you for having this. Any thoughts about IPL?
Any suggestions, guys? Any suggestions will be.
No, nothing. Everybody, we just have to say this to everybody that just be safe. Stay at home for how much ever time you can. Don't get into unnecessary outings for some time. Just stay safe. Stay at home. We'll surely enjoy IPL even if it's without the crowds.
Yeah.
Whoever is watching this video can come to my place. We'll have fun.
So, Jeshwant, any message from you for the fan club members?
So, the fan club members, everybody I know, as the pandemic is still going on, so I request every one of you just to stay at home. We may have IPL very soon, but with the no crowds. So let's all hope that IPL happen. And everyone, I hope just to stay at home, stay safe.
Abhilash, bro, from your side.
Yeah, from my side, I just want to say thank you for all the fans who are supporting our fan club unconditionally. Thank you very much. And just be safe, guys. Stay at home. We'll have definitely have IPL around October or June. Yeah.
September.
Thank you.
September,
October.
Yeah.
Along the BCCI is looking for around the October and September, the middle window.
Yeah.
They're planning according to it. So we may have. Let's hope for the best one.
Yes. Go Orange Army.
On the count of three, let's everybody say it at the same time.
Okay.
So 1, 2, 3.
Go
Orange
Army.
Yeah,
thank you guys.
Hello. See ya guys. Have fun. Stay safe. Yeah, see you next time.
Stay safe, guys.
See you.
Bye.
Bye.